turned in my essay.
Really?
Yep. I decided to write about sex. Ooh, looks like fall has finally arrived.
Here. Take this.
Thanks.
I respect your decision.
You do?
Yeah. And lots of people told me not to write about my brother's death, but I did it anyway. Now I'm the it guy. I just hope I'm not a part of what makes talking about sex scary for you.
No, not at all. It's not about you. It's about me and all the weird details I can't help but notice.
Like what?
Like, when we're having sex at your place, mm-hmm. if the window is open, then the guy across the way can hear us, which I think he wants to hear us, which makes me not want him to hear us. So then we close the window, but it gets too hot. So then we turn on the air conditioning, and there's this weird draft over your bed that hits one of my legs, and I get cold. So we open the window again, and we're right back where we started.
Well, I had no idea any of that was going on.
Welcome to my mind.
It's very funny stuff.
Thanks. I mean, it's not like I'm gonna make a living off of it or anything, but I find it satisfying to write about. Having sex in a city with so many people crammed together, it makes for some pretty odd situations, I think.
Seems like you found your voice. It's extremely clever. I'm happy you didn't listen to me.
Me too. I just wish you hadn't filled me with self-doubt for a week.
Oh, come on, a week is nothing. Try years. And self-doubt is a part of the writing process. It makes a writer more interesting.
Yeah, no, I get it. Being tortured is part of being a good writer. But if you knew how much I doubt myself already, you wouldn't have felt the need to chime in.
Babe, you just need to constantly dig. You can't go too deep.
But maybe I don't want my boyfriend to be the guy cranking the rack in my head dungeon. Maybe I want my boyfriend to be the one who makes me feel safe and cocooned.
Do you want to be comfortable or be good?
Can I be both?
Not if you want to write stuff that really matters.
Suddenly, I realized this itchy coat and Weaver were the same thing. They made me feel uncomfortable in my own skin.
Here. I'm fine.
Why don't you wear it? You're freezing.
Because I would rather be cold than be in something that doesn't feel right. And this doesn't feel right.
Is this us?
I don't know. Maybe it's because we're so similar. Because we're both writers. Because we think too much. Because we're always doubting. I don't want everything to be so uncomfortable.
You don't want to really look at yourself, but that's what makes a good writer.
I hear you. And I'm grateful that you taught me being unsafe is part of being a good writer. But I don't think it's part of being in a good relationship.
What is a good relationship? Being with a guy who doesn't challenge you?
No, but it's not being with someone who relishes doing that.
Okay, you can try to blame all this on me, but our relationship never stood a chance. You never stopped comparing it to your old one. And I know exactly who the he is who makes you feel all cozy.
What do you mean?
Sebastian? I may have read more of your journal than I originally let on. And I saw his name in there a lot. Even when you mentioned me, it was in comparison to him. I remember one line you wrote about how we weren't going to see each other for a whole week. It's nice to finally miss someone new. Very poetic. You were still referencing him. It was always really about him.
Isn't that what people do? Compare their new relationships to their past ones?
I guess. You're supposed to feel like the new relationship you're in is better. You obviously don't.